This is my 1/10 scale RC Knight Rider kit car, and I wanted to go over the electronics. So I'm using a jumper T18 as the transmitter, and I used a custom Lua script to control it. So this is basically just a modification of the standard touchscreen demo libGUI that comes loaded on the jumper T18. What I did was I added a custom script, and I added a custom graphic on the left side for like kids control panel, put some custom text on it. Then I also added a menu. So over here on the right side, you can scroll through, there's 16 different sounds, and you can scroll through them. Each one that you push, it'll trigger just to push the button sound that you hear in Knight Rider. Then I've got over here three basic like hot buttons for the headlights, turbo boost, and the scanner. So the interesting thing about this is what I'm doing, I've got an XR8 receiver in the car and I'm using S-Port. And it's a little finicky, but what I'm basically doing is sending a numerical value over the smart port. And when the Arduino receives that, that's what triggers it based on the number to play a different sound. So there's a Arduino Nano Every inside the car that's hooked up to a DF player, and that's what's playing the sounds. So the car itself is a resin printed body. It was actually three pieces because my resin printer is not big enough to print the whole thing out and then sand it glued together. The whole thing is sitting on top of a TTO2, and then I've got magnetic mounts so that the body comes on and off and I don't have to have any pins. In the front here, there's a Nano Every. Then that one's just controlling the scanner. It's basically hooked up to, I think, 8 LEDs and just cycles back and forth. In the very front right here for the lights, there's addressable RGB strip, which just turns on white. Then in the back, there's another addressable RGB strip. This is for the red lights. Then in here, there's, like I said, a Nano Every in there. Arduino board and the DF player, and I just tucked it into this box because the wires were really a mess. But the real magic behind this is I'm using the S-Port. The only problem is, and I kind of tried to edit around it in the video, is it's a little inconsistent, especially when the transmitter is closer to the car. It doesn't always pick up the signal whenever I push the button or get the data that I'm sending. So if anybody's got any suggestions on how to make that a bit more reliable, I'd appreciate it. But other than that, I think it works pretty good. The cool thing about this is you could use this to control just about anything because you could trigger different functions on a robot, different functions on a rover and things like that. It's basically just programming this touchscreen, whatever you wanted it to do, you can make a button. So it's a pretty flexible thing. I'll have the code posted up on my website and then I'll just end this video with a couple more sounds and the Knight Rider intro just because I like it. Thanks for watching.
Unsafe, unsound behavior, if you ask me.
So I've got it set up so that at 50% or anything below 50%, the brake lights come on. And then above 50%, they go off. And then it'll start to move. I'm not gonna drive it because I don't want to drive off the table. And then there's a
RF signal critical.
Let's put a kill switch on it just because I don't want to drive. I'm just worried about the body because the body's resin printed and it is fairly fragile if it's gonna crash into anything. This wasn't designed to actually drive around. So the hub gaps are resin printed. They're actually just snapped on. I'm not gonna mess with them, they're gonna pop off. But these are just standard Tamiya tires that came with the car. And then I bought some metal rims and then put those on there. So it's not exactly the same because I think the actual Knight Rider kit has more spokes on the rim. But it looks close. And lastly, on the back, I had to have the Knight license plate on there. Not the best paint job. And then the rear lights are basically, it's painted over, and then I put a vinyl mask on top of it so that the rear lights shine through.